can't get out of this hole we're in. Can you get out and go tell the car behind us we're rolling back, please?
Yeah, here, talk to Kate.
Okay, thanks. Air supply is low and the clutch is overheating.
Good luck.
Yeah, I had my co-driver get out and tell the guy behind us to back up so we can roll back a little bit. Can you just get in your seat? They're gonna spin into it.
I'm sorry.
Update. What's going on?
It's 15 degrees. It's blowing snow. You can't see anything in front of me. He's really light too. I don't know how he's going. Anyways, I went ahead and let the cop in front know we're back here. He said there's nothing we can do. We did everything we were supposed to do and we're just gonna have to wait now. There's a guy behind us and he's just gonna sit here with us. And so, yeah, we'll just let it, I don't know. We're just gonna sit here and wait. Wait for whatever to happen. While I was running around doing stuff, Bodhi was busy pushing people from being stuck, the cars. Obviously not the trucks. Or else I'd have them push us out of the way. Oh gosh, I feel like there's so much water on my face.
What are we doing right now?
I'm trying
trying to push us out of the way?
I guess so. He wants those parts of it, but I have to feel like I'm here. This trailer's gonna come over here.
This guy.
I don't think the officer wants anybody to pass right now. It's not safe.
Yeah.
It's literally 15 degrees outside and the blowing snow makes it really cold, and we were pushing cars out of the way with a police officer back there. The tow truck came by on eastbound and he yelled and he was like, hey, if you can get everybody out of the way, he can tow us to the top. And anyway, so I asked the officer if after we're pushing everybody out of the way, the guy behind me, my lip is numb. We're trying to back up this truck that's stuck behind me. I can't talk. And so he's got some snow under his tires. So I was thinking, well, maybe if we dig out the snow, we have a chance. He's too close to my trailer and he can't back up right now. Oh, God, it's cold. Oh boy, this heat is like too much. It's burning. Oh, everything is burning.
I don't want to be out here being responsible for other people hitting each other, so.
Frustrated.
Okay, you're gonna, don't worry about your hook right now. You're gonna put it in drive. Me and you are gonna date. I want you to pull up with me. Try not to spin. Just move with me. Like we're dancing.
We're gonna dance. That's what we're gonna do. Downgrade, and I'm gonna go slow as hell down this. I don't have any chains on my trailer. I didn't really have a place where I could pull over and really put them on. I could have put them on while I was sitting, but I couldn't roll, so they wouldn't have been tight, so they would have broken anyway. So slow we go down the hill. Does anybody behind me going down the hill have their CB on? Awesome, I'm the leader, so I'll let you know when we stop.
I'm just coming out of the mountain.
Okay, well we have spots of no visibility, so just beware.
Thank you.
No problem.
This is so much fun, I forgot how
it was. Hell yeah, man. Send it. Ended. It's been a little bit. I've been mostly rolling like 10 miles an hour. I rolled 10 miles an hour down the entire grade. And most people followed me till I got to the chain up area to take them off, because it's been really, really freaking dark and you can't really park on the side of the road. Plus the wind gusts, it's just really dangerous. So I waited to get to here. I went tops 15 miles an hour because some of it was dry and bare. And you don't want to travel on chains really fast. Like, your max speed should be 30 miles an hour, even though like some chains say 35. I mean, honestly though, if there's snow on the ground and you need chains, you should probably be going 20 and under. And that's just my two cents. Take it for whatever you want to take it for. And just, I have a lot to learn still. Even though I'm almost 4 years into this, I still have so much to learn. I learned how to do a different set of chains today too. And you know, it's every day you learn something. You gotta go along with that. But man, today was fun. Today was freaking fun. I mean, got to help people, push people out. It was nice to like connect with people one-on-one and actually be like, hey dude, I got your back, I'll push your car, like just start going in that direction. There's so many cars that we pushed out of the way. I know, you just need love. Ew. Anyways, I'm gonna go take the chains off now, and I think we'll end this video here. And I really hope you guys got a little bit of tidbit information about chaining. I want to do an official chain video that's more thorough. This was just winging it, so hopefully this helps people, because I know this needs to get out there like now, because I know there's lots of people that need help. So I hope this helps you, and I hope that you guys are safe. And just remember, get a CB, talk to the other trucks on the road, let them know what's ahead. Other people will let you know what's ahead. It's just, it's so important. The tow truck driver and I, I'm sure you saw, him and I communicated via the CB. So anyways, it was just, today's been cool. And I'm gonna take the chains off now. And I've been driving, I started this morning at 4. I'm pretty sure I probably drive past my drive time, but if you guys know the rules, you're allowed 2 hours extra for inclement weather or having to get out of a situation like this. So I'll have to fix that on my logs later. I'll probably have to call tech support and figure out how to do it, because I really don't know how. But again, learning. Every step is learning. So just remember, be open-minded, learn, help people. That's the way it should be. We're family out here. Like, everybody, we gotta look out for everybody on the road, because, you know, it's just been great. It's been a great day. And I'll see you in the next one. Right, right, Dakota? Can you say bye to the camera? Bye, guys. You should let me know.